Okay, so in this video, I want to look at the idea of what's called a parent document retriever. So this is something that becomes really useful in RAG. And it's good to understand the difference between LLMs and embeddings here. So while there are embeddings used a lot in LLMs, here we're looking at embeddings for retrieval. And they act quite differently. So whatever we can actually put in context learning for an LLM, as long as we've got a decent model, it's pretty good at being able to work out what is relevant and what is not relevant. So when you've got a decent quality model for RAG, if you put a lot of things in there, as long as you don't put too many in there to confuse it, you'll find that it's actually pretty good at being able to extract out pieces of information. So you might have something like this, where you've got a bunch of different documents. This is taken from an earnings call for Google. And here you can see we've got Sundar Pichai giving an update about various products, about earnings, about things like that. Now, you could imagine that in this particular call, they talk about a whole bunch of different detailed stuff. So we don't want to put the whole thing in there, right? Really, to get a better result, we want to help the language model as much as possible and sort of trim out the bits that are not relevant. And that's what RAG is all about. And with a conventional sort of RAG, we have something like this, where we have our original documents. We then split those documents. So let's say this is one of them. We split it up into multiple parts, and then we take an embedding for each of these parts. Now, remember that this embedding is a representation of all the semantic details that are in this particular part. So if this particular split doc here is going to be quite big, then the embedding can get very sort of washy, right? It can be non-specific. Whereas that part of the document is quite small, the embedding can be actually quite specific. So you could imagine that if you've got a document where they're talking about, say, earnings, and they're comparing different products or different things like that, and if multiple figures are being used and multiple descriptions are going to be used, the embedding for that particular thing is going to be more sort of general about the earnings. Whereas if we split them up so that, you know, the one part is about, okay, this is how much money Ads made, and then another part is this is how much money that Bard made, and this is how much money that Palm2 made, or something like that, you find that the embeddings then are going to be much more specific to the particular question that we want. That said, though, often we want to make use of the fact that the large language model can actually handle multiple things in there, because it might actually want to do a comparison to be able to say that, okay, this particular product this much, and we can see that it earned more in comparison to product A and product B. And to do that, we'd want a specific embedding for the chunk that we want, but then we want to sort of pass in a bigger chunk of the overall sort of context in here. And this is where parent document retrievers come in. So the idea here is that where you've got your original document and you split it up into sort of chunks that are a decent size, we're going to call those the parent chunks. And then rather than do a straight embedding on those, we're going to take those parent chunks and split them up into child documents, right? So we've got the parent documents, and then we've got the child documents. And you might find that one parent document actually has three child documents. And remember, all the content from these just comes from the parent document in here. But now we make an embedding for each of these child documents. So you can see now we've got three different embeddings describing what before we only had one embedding for. So the idea here is that we're getting a much more specific representation with our embeddings that as we go through this. Finally, when we want to actually use this, we have our question embedding that lines up to the child doc. But what we can then pass back is rather than just pass back this child doc, we actually pass back the parent doc so that the parent doc has got a lot more context in it. So the question is able then to, you know, the large language model gets a bigger context, but the embedding representation is on a much smaller context. So it's going to be much more specific. And then the large language model can take advantage of having the extra context that's in there. That's what parent document retrievers do. let's jump into the code and have a look at how you would do this in LangChain. All right, let's have a look what's going on here. So one of the things I'm doing different in this notebook is I'm actually using the BGE embeddings rather than the OpenAI embeddings. I'm bringing in a zip file of some of the LangChain blog posts here that I've basically just scraped and saved to text files in there. And we're going to use that for doing this, the searching. All right, so the parent document retriever has two ways to use it. One of the ways I explained in the section before, but let me just go through these two ways and we'll look at both ways in code. So the first one is rather than sort of return bigger chunks, we return the full documents. So if our documents are not that long, one of the things that we can do is just use the documents as like the parent documents so that when the smaller chunks do the lookup, they just return back the original document. This can be really good if your original documents, let's say you've got a lot of them, but each one in itself is not very big. So this could be like product descriptions, things like that, where maybe it's like a half page of text and it's like one article for each of those docs. And maybe you've got a lot of them in there. You can then split those up into smaller chunks, do the lookup on those, but then return back the actual full document for that. The second way is more like what I explained before with the diagram, is that you're going to return the bigger chunks from a smaller chunks lookup. So let's have a look at these. So we're just doing some standard imports. We're importing the parent document retriever here. We're going to basically have some text splitting and stuff like that. I've commented out the stuff on the OpenAI embeddings, but I've left it in there so that if you want to use that, you can use that. The embeddings that I'm using in here are the BGE embeddings. I'm using the small, and these have just been recently updated, I think, as well, the small 1.5 embeddings. And these are tiny, like the whole embedding model is only 134 meg. Now I'm running it with a T4 in the Colab here. If you don't have access to a GPU, just drop back to the OpenAI embeddings as you go through this. All right, so I'm bringing in a couple of these blog posts here. I'm bringing in one that's announcing Langsmith, another one that's about benchmarking QA. And we can see that, sure enough, when I bring these in, I've got two documents. If we look at one, you can see the way I've scraped them is I've saved the title and the URL to this. And we could actually sort of filter those out if you wanted to have them as metadata. But here, you know, basically I've got the URL first, and then I've got the title here for the blog post. And then I've just got the text for the blog. So this is using a custom scraper that I built. Oh, maybe I'll release this as open source. It's actually quite simple to do for this. So in this case, each doc is one full blog post here. Now, what we're going to do then is we're going to split these up into smaller chunks. And we're going to be using, you know, a child splitter here. We're going to use the recursive character splitter. And I'm just taking these settings basically from the LangChain docs in here. Now, of course, I've swapped out the embeddings to basically use the BGE embeddings. If you were using the OpenAI ones, just uncomment this and delete this out. And then we've got our full-size docs are going to be in a store that's going to be in memory here. So here you can see our full doc retriever is going to be a parent document retriever with our vector store, which is the small chunks that we've split up, the full size docs in the doc store, and then we've just passed in the child splitter. So when we do this add documents, it will run through, it will basically make the embeddings for us, it'll put it all together. Now, if we look at the store in here, we can see that there's only two documents in there. So in this case, we've only got two blog posts in there, but these are the idea is that they're the big chunks in this. If I do a vector store similarity search for, you know, what is Langsmith, and I set it to just k equals 2 coming back, you see, sure enough, I get two docs coming back. And if I go in and look at one of these docs, we can see that this first doc is basically today we're introducing Langsmith platform, right? And we can see that it's not very long. It's just a few sentences long in there. So this is the small split in there. Now I've got two of those coming back. If I pass the what is Langsmith into the full doc retriever, what it does is goes and works out what are those small chunks, but then it works out what the parent chunks are. In this case, those parent chunks are the full docs. and then it returns those. So you can see here, if I say, okay, what is Lang Smith? Sure enough, I'm getting the sort of matching full doc for this first one here. And we can see while this one was just probably a few hundred characters long, what we get back here is 11,600 characters long. And that's because it's the full post in here. And sure enough, what post is going to be announcing Lang Smith in there? So this is one way that you can do it with the whole thing in one shot. The other way that you can do it is just retrieving larger chunks. And this one you would use where if you're passing in the full document, it's just going to be too big. So let's say now your full documents are multi-page documents. You don't want to pass the full document into the language model at the end. So now we have to have sort of two layers. We have to have the original documents, the parent chunks, and then the child chunks, or the big chunks and then the small chunks in here. So again, we're going to use the child splitter that we had before, but now we've got the parent splitter, which you'll notice is a much bigger size, right? So we've got 2000 for the parent splitter, and we've got 400 for the child splitter in. So again, these are just taken from LangChain's docs. You would experiment around with what's the right size for your particular thing. We've then got our chroma setting up again using our BGE embeddings. We've got the store, the same as before. There's nothing different now. The only thing now is that when we create the parent document retriever, we've got both a child splitter now and a parent splitter. So we're going to have multiple layers of docs. And in this doc store now is going to be the big chunks, right, in there. We've got those two blog posts. When we look at the store now, we can see they've been split into 18 big chunks. That's because each of those is, you know, roughly 2,000 characters long. The sub-docs, when we do our search, you know, these are going to be much smaller. So the sub-docs now, when I do a search, I get four of them back. All right, when I look at the first one, sure enough, we can see today we're introducing Lang Smith, and we can see, okay, what's going on there. And I could change the K for the number of ones I'm getting back there, right? The standard default is 4. Earlier on, I changed it to 2. Okay, now we can see if we do the sort of retrieved big docs, so this is big chunks retriever, get relevant documents, what is Lang Smith? You can see now, sure enough, we've got only 2 docs coming back. And when we look at them, they're big, but they're not the full document. They're not the full blog post like we had before. But if we look at the two that we get back, sure enough, we've got this one, which is the start of the blog post about that. And if we look at the second one, it's probably also, looking at it, looks like it's also from that blog post, but it's a different part of the blog post. So now we've got 2 chunks of the blog post as 2 separate things that we're going to pass into the in-context learning. And then finally, just to sort of finish it up and try it out, we just put together a retrieval QA chain. Here, I'm just using OpenAI for the language model. We basically, you could put in any, you want a decent language model to do this, right? But you could certainly put in the Llama 2 models should work pretty well for this. We're just going to pass everything into in-context learning. And you can see at the retriever, I'm just passing in the big chunks retriever now. So now when I say, what is Lang Smith? It's going through, it's running the queries to get the small chunks and then from those getting the big chunks back. And you notice that early on, remember, we had the 4 sub chunks, but they only gave us back 2 big chunks. So there obviously overlaps in those, which is a good sign. And sure enough, we can see here that, okay, what is Lang Smith? Now we're getting a proper thing that's going through a language model at the end. Lang Smith is a platform designed to help developers close the gap between prototype and production, and we've got a full, you know, answer now for this. So this shows you how you can use the parent document retriever. It's very useful for a lot of different things where you've got a lot of sort of fine-grained information, so you want embeddings that are very specific, but you also want to return back a bigger context for the language model at the end to be able to give a good coherent answer for this. Anyway, as always, if you've got questions, please put them in the comments below. If you found the video useful, please click like and subscribe. I've got a few more of these videos coming out about different things about retrievers and tips and tricks about using this for RAG going forward. All right, I will see you in the next video. Bye for now.